Welcome back. If you have come this far, it means that you're done with your title and abstract screening and ready to look at those full texts. The good news is doing full text screening is not that much different from title and abstract screening on HubMeta. Let's take a quick look. Just like we did in title and abstract screening, I will present how this full text screening is different for the reviewer and for the researcher of the project. So right now I'm logged in as Giraffe the reviewer. I'll open my project, go to full text screening. I have a bunch of PDFs to look at. So as you can see, not all of them already have a PDF. The ones that do have this icon displayed right next to them. For the articles that do not yet have a full text attached to them, it's usually a good practice to share the task between the members of the project and ask them to go and find a full text. Note that the PDF that is uploaded by any member will be shown to all members of the project. Once the PDFs are uploaded, however, the reviewing process is pretty much the same as what it was in title and abstract screening. Here you can submit your votes and of course select the reasons why you believe they should be included or they should be rejected. And of course, you might want to use these filters that you have on the right. And that's pretty much anything that a reviewer would need. Let's go and see how full text screening looks for the researcher of the project. Here I'm logged in as the researcher. So let's open the project, go to full text screening. These are the full texts. And as you can see, I can already see some votes submitted by my reviewer. And I can submit my decision to whether reject or accept this paper. Up top, I have this little dashboard which shows me first the number of reviews already submitted by my reviewers and the number of papers that I have made a decision about. And there's also this meter for discrepancies, which I will talk about in the next video. One thing that I've found very useful in full text screening as the researcher is how you use these filters. So in this project with actual data, you can see up top, I can see the progress of my different reviewers. And this basically says how many papers were rejected, received a maybe vote, or were accepted into the final project. And this one shows the rate of discrepancy. And of course, this one is based on my decisions as the researcher of the project. Basically, I have accepted 60% of articles in full text screening and rejected 40% of them. Let's take a look at filters. What I like to use in filters as the researcher is look at the comments. For example, one thing that I usually want to do is when one reviewer has submitted a yes vote and the other has submitted a maybe. When I do that filter, it's kind of suggestive that maybe this should be accepted. And I have the option to accept all the ones that are filtered now. If I click on this, I'm telling HubMeta to accept all the ones which reviewer number one said yes and reviewer number two said maybe. I can do a similar thing with no and maybe and filter again and, you know, basically say, okay, if one said no, the other said maybe, maybe it's best to reject them. Of course, with rejects, I will be a little bit more careful because I don't want to miss data point that is out there. So we'll take a quick look at the actual articles and look at their files to see if I agree with this decision. If I did for a few of them, then I will make a decision to reject. Of course, there are no accepted rules about this, so it's completely up to you how you make your decisions. But I'm just pointing out that using these filters and these accept all, reject all features, you can make your full text screening decision making as the researcher a lot more faster. In the next video, we'll talk about discrepancies in reviewer votes and how to report and how to handle them.